Hello friends, this is Adam with MovieGuy365, and today I'm going to review Barry Levinson and Robert Redford's The Natural in 4K. If you're new to the channel, please hit the like button, subscribe, hit that bell notification. I put out videos daily. You can also find me over Twitter and Instagram at MovieGuy365. The Natural. Oh my god, it's been years since I've seen this movie. Oh my god, I'm a big fan of Barry Levinson. I'm a huge fan of Robert Redford. This movie has such a stellar cast. Barbara Hershey, Glenn Close, Robert Duvall, Wilford Brimley's in this. I have such fond memories of this film, and I even think this is one of those occasions that the director's cut version, which has floated around for years, also just elevates it to a new level. And proudly that they did include it in this 4K disc. Sony, I mean, I'm just going to gush about it, but Sony did an amazing job. Like, they are the gold standard as far as 4K goes. And when they did a nice 4K with full of, you know, nice little HDR, you know, pop-outs here and there, it really is such a good look to it. I mean, the film itself is a wonderful movie. It's, you know, the story of Roy Hobbs, and, you know, just going from, like, pretty much nothing to, like, being one of the best there is in the sport. I mean, it is kind of like, you know, you kind of throw it in the same vein as Field of Dreams. While Field of Dreams is not inherently a baseball movie, it's more about, like, a relationship between the father and son. The setting is just, it just harkens back to that. But this is a pure baseball movie. It's like, this is for love of sport. And I could go on and on about this one. Revisiting it after so many years was, it hit some nostalgic points for me. It really did. Just going back to the picture, beautiful, beautiful filmic look to this. This is not a, you know, it's not one of the more modern releases where, you know, HDR is so apparent, but the clean look to the film without sacrificing any of its film look to it. It's a beautiful looking picture. It really is. Oh man, it's really a feast for the eyes. I enjoyed every second of watching it on screen. I did watch the director's cut. I fell in love with this movie all over again. I thoroughly enjoy it. The picture alone is, you know, worth it in my opinion. Now, audio wise, we are given an Atmos track, but it's nothing that's, you know, really overly immersive. You know, I always kind of felt it was just more of a front-heavy, you know, film audio-wise. Occasionally you get a couple things in the rear speakers, but nothing that's really going to show off your system. I still would watch it this way with the surround sound. That's just me personally. But if you are, you know, restricted to your TV speakers, that kind of thing, or soundbar, you're not missing terribly much. And, you know, I'm not a huge believer that you should add ambience or add anything if a movie didn't already have it. So by adding stuff into the background, I don't know, it would have felt a little disingenuous. But damn, this is, if you are a fan of this movie in any way, shape, or form, Sony has just really given us something here. And you are going to be extraordinarily pleased. I highly recommend you pick up The Natural in 4K. You get it for a very decent price. Nice looking slipcover. You get both versions of the movie, theatrical and director's cut. I prefer the director's cut, but you gotta get it. You gotta get it. It's a beautiful looking disc, and that's all I can really say about it. So let me know in the comments below, are you a fan of The Natural? I sure as hell I am. I'm not gonna wait nearly as long before I watch it again, but it's one of the classics, it really is. So let me know, and in the meantime, please like, subscribe, hit that bell notification. I put out videos every single day. So until next time, this is Adam with Movie Guy 365. I will see you at the movies.